Hey everyone, I'm Felipe Schmidt. In today's video, we are going to talk about something in the employee center they're called standard ticket page. So basically, first we're going to talk about what is that for and how we can configure that page so that we can filter all types of requests to show in that page. So let's do it. Everything starts in here, in the employee center, as we are used to. And if we go to my requests, we're going to see all types of requests that are being available in here in this page. So whenever you come here to see the requests, you can see incidents, you can see requests, you can see everything that you can configure that I'm going to show to you in a few minutes. And basically, that's the first step. How we can make use of it so that we can filter all the requests in here. And the second step is the standard ticket page. So whenever you click in a record, you can see the ticket page of that. So basically here, you can configure this look and feel so that you can see the number here at the top. You can see fields like created, like updated, state. Anyway, everything that is in here, everything is configurable. Of course, it has some limitations in here in which types of fields you can display, for example, here at the top or here below, but most of the things here you can do and you can configure. Now, let's go to the part so how we can configure it. If you go to the backend, the first thing that you need to look for is request filter. And here is basically under service catalog, is where you can find my request filter. And this is basically everything that you can see. So you can see it applies for a portal and it applies for this table. And this is the title only so that you can easily find in here this record. And let's filter it for active true, which is already in here. I'm going to filter for applies for service portal. And we can see that we can see incident, request, service catalog tasks and requested items in here. Let's make a new one simply by creating new so that we want to see some change requests in here as an example so that we can filter the change requests in there. And if we go to change request and we want to say here that is change requests and it applies for service portal and we want only to show the active true. This is only an example. Of course, here, whenever you are going to production, you are going to have filters like open by is dynamic me or stuff like this. You are free to choose which is the type of condition in here that you can add and you should add. And basically here is the most important thing to which page it's going to be redirected whenever the user clicks on that record that is going to be shown in there. And here is the primary field to display. So basically, whenever you are in the list in here, what is the field that is going to be shown whenever it loads? That is going to be shown in here at the top, for example. In that case, for incident is going to be the short description. And here we can also say, okay, for change request, we also want the short description. And in here, you can also say some secondary fields, like for example, the open by or maybe requested for, stuff like this. And if I save in here, again, just to make sure that everything is clear, I'm not adding any type of limitation in here in this record to say, this is only my change requests. Otherwise, this is all the active change requests that are going to be shown in here. So it might take a while to load because we might have lots of change requests in here, but the most important thing is to show that everything is going to be loaded right now. So whenever you go here, as you can see, now we have the change requests that we have configured and we have all of them and we have the state, we have the updated. And this is something that if you go back to my request filter, you're going to see that now we have our active applies to portal is everything related to here. and now our change request in here. So if I want to just set it inactive, just to make sure that everything is working fine, I can simply set it to inactive, and you're going to see that the record is going to disappear from the list. So now we don't have any kind of change request in here. And that's the first step. So right now, this is very useful whenever you are working in, for example, in an application, something for the customer in which you want to make use of it to show in this list any kind of custom record. So you can simply configure here for your table so that everything is going to show to be shown in the service portal or in the employee center in this case. So saying that, now we have the first step, how we can collect the records to be shown in here. Now we're going to the second step. And the second step is, okay, whenever you click, let me just refresh that again. You're going to see that we don't have any kind of standard ticket page for change requests. So whenever you click in this, so this is the out of the box, so to say. And what we need to do right now is to configure this in a better way, so to say. So if we go right now to the standard ticket page, which is a new scope in here, so change request. So we see that we don't have anything right now. And what we can do, we can also make sure that we don't have anything inactive, but now what we can do is to simply, let's see if we don't have anything for change. No, we don't. So we're going to create a brand new one so that we can configure in our way. So whenever you go here, you can see change request, and then you can configure all the most specific fields that are going to be shown on that page. And the info region, for example, is going to be the region at the top in here, that whenever you click, for example, here is everything that is going to appear at this rollback Oracle version in here. Let's configure that. So here we can say that the description of the record is always going to be shown or not. And we're going to leave it like this to make it more visible, so to say. And the description is simply the description field. Advanced is whenever you want to use a widget for that to show some specific fields. Basically, this is very useful whenever you have some customer requirements that you need to pick some, to do some glide records, to grab some records from somewhere else. This is very useful in this kind of situation. You're not going to use that so much, only in very specific scenarios. And here in the info fields is basically everything that you can, add so that you can use for your specific requirement. We're going to add some in here. And as you can see, in this specific situation, ServiceNow says that we are not allowed to add some fields in this info field, for example, the number and state. And this is a very good example that explains that we are not allowed to add every kind of field in here. So we are going to remove this and this, and we are going to save. So we are going to see that we can add some fields, but not every kind of field. So whenever you go back here to my request right now, if I refresh the page, you're going to see some new fields in here. Planned start date, planned end date, and requested by, as exactly as you described in here in the info fields. And here is the description as we have mentioned and the advanced. But right now, the most important thing to notice is that whenever you create this ticket configuration, the tab configurations also come along. So if you see activity and attachments, they come along in here. So activity, which is the activity log, that you can see everything related to the additional comments of this ticket, as well as all the attachments in here. And let's say you want to add some new specific thing, you can always come to new and you can make use of this order field so that you can add new tabs. One example of something that is very useful is sometimes you want to add some specific tab for all the variables, how the user has submitted, for example, a record producer. And then you have, you can separate in a specific tab all the specific variables that that user has submitted in that specific request. So whenever you come here, for example, you have variable summarizer, which is one of them, variable editor, in which is read-only mode, so to say, and then you have activity, as we already have, and some others. And of course, we have also a custom, in which we can bind a widget and show specific records or specific information based in a widget itself. So we are free really to code whenever we need some specific information. So in our specific example, we have added a new custom tab in which the custom tab calls a widget. So whenever you come in here, you can see that there is a new tab called Hello World, and it shows exactly the information that is inside of the widget. That's how you can make use of it. And you can extend that as however you prefer. What we can say also that is very important about the standard ticket configuration on that page is basically, so if we go to change requests in here, this is what we have just created, and we go inside of the record, we have the info fields, so the info region, and then we have our action region. And this action region is exactly, you can think about UI actions that you can play around for a specific use case. So let's say you want to enable the end user to simply close the request from there, is something that you can easily configure in here from the action region. And in this action region in here is something that you need a widget to show something at this part. I'm going to pick an example from the incident part so that you can see exactly how is that made. You see that there is something called incident standard actions, and this specific widget in here, it simply catches some of the UI actions code that you can simply bind inside of this widget, so that this is going to be shown exactly into, I'm going to show exactly from the widget itself, from the incident. So this is the wrong one. So I have a widget in here that is in new, so that you can see the actions. And then you have exactly the UI actions itself, which is the resolve one. And basically you can have conditions, for example, whenever the incident is on state new, the end user is able to click on resolve, for example. And you can have such logic, which is aligned, for example, with something that is happening on the backend. And then you are free to do however you prefer. And you can always go to the standard ticket page, official documentation from ServiceNow, which will guide you how to find specific information in here that I might have not talked about, but this is also possible to do so. So the key takeaways from this video are, whenever you have some kind of record in which you need to show to the end user, so that is going to be available for them to see and review what they have submitted, you can always make use of the My Request widget. And in here, you need the request filter in which you can collect all kinds of records that are going to appear in here. And for the second part is to configure the standard ticket page, in which you can configure which fields and which information is going to be shown to the end user in the specific page of that record. So for example, in this case for incident, you have the tabs and you have all the information displayed here at the top. Hope it's clear. If you have any suggestions or comments, you can always add here and let us know your thoughts. Don't forget the like button as well as to subscribe to the channel. We keep in touch.